principal, I mean, the bursar, at that time, the head of the school was here too, because we didn't have a high school built until 1962. So all high school and grade school was all girls, with the exception of preschool and kindergarten and first grade. We took in the boys then, but then once they were ready to go to third grade, they had to leave the school, which the parents were happy about, but that's the way the sisters wanted. So we could walk down the hall, and here's the history of the building of the school. So originally, we'll start here. This is the house called the Villa that was on this property. And the school, as I said, was being built in front. So this is the stages up to the final picture at the end.
And when we're finished, we just pick it up.
Okay. Your mother would have been in the chapel. And everyone, even the Jewish children, were invited to be here at school and to come to the chapel. If their parents insisted that they not have chapel time, then they were, they had a study hall, some recreation time. But anyway, the air in here has been cut because last year we ended up putting protective glass on the stained glass. And the area we have for fresh air in here is in the negative. It's a little long. We will have an air conditioner in the front.
It's our awesome video. If you move that fast, it's very, just barely new. It just takes stills. It's fast like that.
Anyway, come this way. So I'll show you the areas actually where your mother would have been, because above us was the high school area. Now this is one of the sisters. She taught music here, and she actually came in 1918. And her name is Sister Eileen. So, if your mother at an early age was inclined to play the piano or something, she would have taken lessons from Sister Eileen. Okay. As I said, we're getting ready for our graduation tomorrow night of the 8th graders.
So our acting starts, it goes to him, and then he's
these were the dining halls when your mother was here. So one side was for the high school. This was the grade school dining hall. Right now it is a Montessori classroom. But it's quite large, and but you know, as I said, you have the expansion. Montessori classrooms needed this space. Hey, Steve. Hi. So, this is where all the children would be, along with the high school children, or students, for grand ensemble. And that is quarterly. The students would get their awards for the grades. And I'm sure your mother was intelligent, she was smart, so she probably ended up receiving awards. She would at least have two grand ensembles before she got out. The sisters with them brought French traditions, and the children, even way down to kindergartners, had an actual cross to wear and a belt. And if you were Jewish, you had the Star of David. As they received awards, if she had very, very good grades, she was given a grand cordon. So it is a sash that even the children wear their Concord for a quarter until it was time for another round of assembly, and they, you know, they didn't keep their grades up, they lost their quarter, but that was something to look forward to. Actually, I'll show you this cabinet.
Charles, if you do a video, we're going to run out of chips.
Okay.